This is Skix, part two of the Ghibli Craft series here. These are three builds that I have made. This is the Tower of Doom. The first one I showed was the Alien Outpost. So this is the Tower of Doom. You'll notice it is circled by seagulls, and when we get to the top, you'll see there's something else exciting up there. We're going to start at ground level, go to the top, then we're gonna find the secret in the basement. All three of my builds have a secret in the basement. This cute little bridge. Originally, these were two separate plots. This road here split right between them. But then once I got the rank, I had the ability to merge plots, and I did that thing. So let's see. Remember what I assumed the entrance point was. I think it was the bridge. There's the basement down there. And as with the other build, there are a couple different ways to get down there because I want people to find it. Doom Tower Hotel. Sort of as an afterthought, I decided to sloppy with the shulking boxes there. I decided to make the ground floor hotel lobby. Fireplace, bookshelves, all sorts of different cool stuff. I'm going to spend a lot of time on each floor because there are 19 of them. This is floor zero, the ground floor. The European that brings down, not the American. So the first floor is the first. Floor one is a barracks. Got these new closets. Really like how the trunks look in this resource pack. We've got a patio. See more of that at the top of the stream. The water stream. I'm not streaming this. Whoops. Second floor. Stop walking because the footsteps are loud and it's going to take a while. Second floor. I like the item frame on the door, but unfortunately, the item frame stays put. But then this hallway doesn't really go anywhere. We've got this little garden. We've got these. Your bathtub, watch out for the toaster. This is, what is that? Red stained glass for some reason. It's white, but when you have it as a single piece like that, it makes a wheel. Nifty little things about the resource pack. We've got this patio that goes all the way around the floor. I am a fan of patios and verandas and balconies. I think they really help make a simple build more interesting. Third floor. Tried to do some diagonaling, which could be tough. The water flow is outside the ground edge of the balcony. Fireplace, sofas that are a little high. These half blocks are retextured dye from inside an item frame. Features like that just are interesting uses of item frames. That's a flower pot with some flowers have, you know, these models of teapots and cups and whatnot. That's floor three. Floor number four is this decided to grow beets. The fire pit. On the wall looks like a pan, on the floor looks like a pan. More of the food. I like using these as flooring. And you gotta use a bit of a world edit trick to make the iron gate stay upright. First build was approved. I got limited use of world edit, so I can do some of those things. And with each rank, I get more plots. I get more magic. This is the butcher shop. Is that toaster again? That's a player head. Seagulls up close, they're fairly simple. Just copy paste and world edit will rotate in 90 or 45 degree increments. We're up to the sixth floor. Really just plants, potted plants. Got the potted plants scattered around. My furnishings are a little vague at times. This one uses brown glass planes as walls, so we now have walls that aren't full blocks. There are some downsides to doing it that way, but I think it's neat, and I will make more use of it at some point. Big pink block. No particular reason. And this one has a second story. Stairs. I don't think I would do that again. It's my neighbor. It's a friend of mine. She's cool. The chapel. To the toaster. What else? Pews, flowers, all beautiful good stuff. This is kind of a weird joined balcony tunnel thing that I tried. I don't think successful. Got our professional. I think it's cute. And there is a gallery above, which is the next floor. You'll notice the talking down below. This is a pretty polite server. It's moderated nicely. We keep racist garbage to a minimum without being too uptight in other ways. And you'll also notice I have my subtitles turned on. I always play with subtitles. There are some odd bugs with subtitles that never seem to get fixed. 10th floor. This is the source of one of the waterfalls, the water streams. See that balcony from the outside? Lava. Sound says there's lava somewhere nearby. Some more food. That's a light daylight sensor. Little balcony. Oh, it's not the one that goes round. Just like these. Just really do. Stained glass. Lovely. 7th floor. Missing a sign for the 7th floor. This is an industrial area. There's the lava flow. Just an industrial level. This isn't inspired a bit by the Dark Tower. The idea that each level is like a different world. This is the source of the other water stream. This is like a basin. Industrial floor below this is a huge pipe that carries the water through and out to the inside. We're up to 12. Lost count. This is a maze. We're not going to walk it in this video, but it is a proper maze that takes you to the center. Trying some different things for the railing of the balcony. Just trying different things. Pipe from below starts here. We've got an aquarium. No fish yet. Not until the next update. We've got this carpet pattern. Climb up the inside of the pipe if you want. Assisted by OllieDG. Ollie did the floor, he did the gutter, he did the balcony. He did a spaceman for some reason. This balcony with satellites on it. And also he's got some free floating satellites up in the air, which we will see momentarily. And just a big view window, which is a view of the Gotham City now, and the fiery pentagram in the sky. One, why not? 16 coming up. 16 on top, did I say 19? 16 floors plus ground is 17, and then 200 underground. So this is sort of a botanical garden kind of thing. And the source of the central water flow. It's that fountain. Now let's go up on the roof. In addition to seagulls, we have chimneys. Terrifying ass angels with wings and eyes, or toaster eyes, and a couple satellites from Ollie. Now, I'll take a little gravity ride. Bam. Hope you don't get motion sick. I actually get a little motion sick when I'm working on ceilings. Got that coming up out of the ground. There's the alien outpost, Goblin City over there. Is the cellar. This, by the way, is my face. I'm wearing pants and grass on my head. But I am a mid-century doctor. Did previous century. Where the hell is the... Alright. At this basement, which is just kind of ground and crumbling. Inside this enclosure is stairs. And it's a long spiral staircase that I don't think I have ever even once climbed all the way down. There's my first attempt at a pentagram. And out here is this sort of weird landscape. Wall of iron bars. It's the bottom side of the pipe. If you break in through the iron bars, there are these stairs that lead up to... Gosh, I can't even remember when that comes out. This is the tunnel into the alien outpost. Let's see. I do not remember. As before, there are multiple ways to get down below because I want to make sure everyone gets a chance. just another waterfall. Anyway, let's see, we've got the spiral staircase going all the way up. We've got all these balconies, chimneys. It's fairly plain. I built like 2-3 floors and then I used world edit to copy them. And then I went floor by floor and made them more interesting. And next we go to the Goblin City.